Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at transit maps. We're going to create them using effects and we are using plugins for them. To be specific, we're going to use the Astute Graphics plugins to create this because with them, it's possible to create these as effects and not moving each stop at the point where you want. Maybe you do not need to create transit maps as part of your job, but you might want to use this for other types of work you need to do. So let's get started. And I'm going to start by creating a rounded rectangle. So this is filled with black. Let's get rid of that. And also let's make these slightly less rounded. And I'm going to create this line as well. And now we want to get those stops. So let's select this. And in order to create these, I'm going to Effect, AG Utilities, and then Make Shape, like this. Now, everything is now first gone. And here we have the shape, which is just a circle. And we need to adjust all these options. So first of all, this replaces the original. So the original rounded rectangle is replaced by the circle that I can specify in here. That doesn't make a lot of sense in this situation. So let's make these above original. That is great, but still it's just in the center. And let's set the location. So it's relative to the bounds, and we can also select different options here. So we can put it along the path. So just that you see where that is, it's here. And then we can also set some distances in them or along those segments like this. Or, and this is where it gets interesting for the transit maps, you can put them at anchor points. So that's how this looks. And now you can specify the diameter of these. And you can also specify the alignment. We will get to that later on because with circles, they are mostly positioned at the top of this. So you can also randomize these. And you see, then this again doesn't make a lot of sense for this positioning. But if we set these by count, then the random makes some more sense. So let's put them at anchor points and take away that one again. And let's go to OK. This is not how transit maps look because the line just crosses those circles and that's not how they should look like. So let's go to the appearance panel and see what's set up currently. And you see, this effect, Make Shape, is applied to the complete path. And that's why this looks the way it looks, because the circles that are made into shapes have the same appearance as the basic stroke. So it's just red with a 10-point stroke. So we want to have them look differently. And in order to get that, we need to build this differently. So what we can do is have another stroke and let's make it black and let's make it thinner like this. You see, this looks differently and let's make them thinner again. And now we have this Make Shape still apply to everything, but we can move that and put it in here. And now you see it's just applied to this black stroke because we just get this in black. It still doesn't look right because it still creates that rectangle. So let's get into the options again. And instead of above original, we can also replace the original like this. And now we have just the circles in black and the base stroke is still in red. Still, we need to have these filled with white. And to get that, we have the fill already. It has been created. So let's make this in white. And let's move it up here. And now we need to have this effect applied to the white as well in order to create our circles. So let's just press the Alt key and move it down there. And now you see we have our nice stops as white circles with a black stroke. That's nice. Of course, we need some more stops along our line. So let's take the pen tool, and then you can put anchor points where you need a stop, just on the existing path. And that's that. And that's how you get your transit line in your map. Let's take a look at other styles we can have with that. So I'm going to select that again. And let's just turn off that stroke and use the shape. And I'm going to make that orange as well. I think it was this orange, like this. And let's get into the effect and take a look at the other options. So instead of using a circle, you can also use a rectangle. And this rectangle, of course, you see currently these are all arranged along that path. So what we can do is, of course, set the width and height of this. I'm going to make it slimmer, like this. And now, in order to see it, let's rotate it by 90 degrees, like this. And now you see the stops look different on that line. And they are currently all crossing that stroke. So that's one style you can have this in, but you can also, of course, say you want them all aligned 45 degrees, but they should be aligned 45 degrees without being matched to those strokes that you have. So they are all 45 degrees and cross that. And of course, maybe you do not want to cross that red base path, but you can also align them differently and have them stick out like this, just like that. And of course, we can also have a different angle. So let's make this 30 degrees. That might look a little nicer, but maybe not. Let's have this again at 90 degrees and have it stick out like this. So maybe you want to have it with a shadow or something like that. So to achieve that, what you can do is duplicate this fill and make the bottom one white, like so. And now let's take a look at the alignment, like this. It's nice. And if we change the alignment of that one, then you get this little shadow, like so. And of course, you can also turn off that and have the stops like this, so that they are just these white notches in that path. Let's take a look at some other options. So with this one, we want to have a station where you can change trains. So maybe this is a different line and you want to have a station that indicates you can change here. So what you can do, let's set a new fill to this and put it up here. And then again, let's go to make shape. And you see we have round stops, which is nice. They indicate that you can change trains. And we can also have them at the anchor points. That's correct. And above is fine as well. And you can just have them at the first point of this path, like so. This is nice. Let's go to OK. And then we can have another fill. I'm going to undo that. I'm just going to duplicate this one. And let's make this in cyan and go here and set this at the last point. And here it's going to be a rectangle like this and have this rotated 90 degrees like this. And of course, it's also aligned like this because it's the terminal station. So that is this. And then you could also have different ones in here. Let's take a look at that. So I want to have different ones because some of the stations, maybe they point to nice tourist spots. So let's have different stations. I'm just going to create some points along this path, like so. And then let's again go to these options and I'm going to create an additional fill. And let's apply make shape to that and put this to all the anchor points like this. But we want to have them styled differently. So what can we do about that? You see, we can put them to corner only or to smooth only. So let's put these to corner only. That's okay. And then let's duplicate this like so. And let's make a different shape. So let's make a rectangle here. And this is just a smooth. Okay, they still look the same, every one of these, because all the points are corner points. Let's change that. So I'm going to select this point and this point, and then let's go to the Astute Graphics Path Scribe. And in here, what we can do is switch them to smooth point, which we have here, convert to smooth point. And then, of course, let's go into outline view. And when we do that, it creates handles. And this is a straight line, so we don't need handles. And what we can do is retract those handles. Let's go here, retract the handles, and this is the other one, and retract those handles as well, just because that is cleaner in that way. So let's go in here again, and let's go to the rectangle and again, and rotate it by 90 degrees and like this. And that's how you can achieve different stations on your transit line. So that's the workflow, how you can use Astute Graphics effects in order to create your transit maps easier.